So today we will look at another kind of relationship between classes in a class diagram, which is called realization. So this is related to the implementation of an interface in Java. So it is represented by a dotted line and followed by a small triangle at its end. So here also the direction of the arrow is very important, similar to the inheritance relationship we studied in class diagram. So here also the direction of arrow is towards the superclass, that is towards the interface which is being implemented by the class. So here there is an interface rotatable which represents all the objects which can be rotated, like table fan, ceiling fan, a car tire, tire of a truck, anything which can be rotated. So here we define two methods in it. Not define, in fact we just declare them, rotate fast and rotate slow. Both are having a public visibility and a void return type. So these methods don't have any kind of definition. So we have just defined an interface, and here we have defined a class called TableFan which is implementing this interface. So whichever class is implementing this rotatable interface has to provide a definition for all its methods. So the table fan is now bound to provide a definition for rotate fast, which is this, and a definition for rotate slow also, which is this. So let's see the UML class diagram parallelly. In rotatable, rotate fast and rotate slow are represented as usual, but in table fan, TableFan can of course add a new functionality of itself, but in our case we have not added, so only the inherited attributes are there, so we need not repeat them here. So this is the UML class diagram, and the dotted straight line and the triangle is with this interface, not this side. So thank you, friends.